Hello everyone, this is David A. Cox with PCClassesOnline.com, and today we are going to be talking all about iCloud. This is a topic a lot of people out there have several questions about, and today it is my goal to go over all of those questions and also clear up many different misconceptions people seem to have about iCloud and the different things that it offers. So let's start with talking about how it works in regards to email. A big misconception people seem to have about iCloud is that it synchronizes your email. It does not actually do that. It will only do that if you create an @icloud.com email address. Otherwise, it's not going to be a feature you're probably going to be interested in. Now, if you have questions about how to get your email to automatically sync, I recommend that you check out one of our other classes that we have available, of course, for free on our website at pcclassesonline.com. Just look for the class called Email Tips, Tricks, and Honest Advice. Next, here we have contacts. Contacts is relatively straightforward. If you put a contact into your iPhone, it's going to automatically go into all of your other devices. Next, we have calendars, which work very simply. Now, if you use another service, like let's say Google Calendars, you may not want to use this feature because do you really want a whole nother set of calendars? But if you don't and you just use the calendar on your computer, this is a great feature because for me, as someone who books a lot of different appointments with clients, I can put something into my calendar on my Mac and know that it's going to go onto all of my other devices. Next, we have notes. And this confuses a lot of people because in order to use notes and have it automatically synchronize, you have to use that @icloud.com email address. Next, we have reminders. Reminders is most closely tied to the iPhone. So let's say I'm on the road and I need to remember that when I get home, I have to put dinner in the oven. While I'm on the road, I might use Siri, the automated assistant, on my iPhone and say, Siri, when I get home, remind me to put dinner in the oven. So then when I walk in the door, my phone, iPad, and Mac are all going to ding at me and remind me to put dinner in the oven. Next, we have Find My iPhone, which will actually track more than just your iPhone. It'll track an iPad, a Mac, or an iPod Touch. Now, here's a big misconception that we can clear up right now. This is not going to help you if your device is stolen. At least it's not likely to. So here's how it works. Let's say I am at a restaurant and I leave my phone on the bar, okay? When I get home and realize the mistake I've made, I can go on my computer or any computer to iCloud.com, sign in with my iCloud account, pull up this app, and as long as my device is online and powered and not wiped, I will be able to track and see on a map where that device is. I can even play a tone which will make it ring. I can have a message appear that says, this phone is lost, please call me so I can get it back. The reason why it won't work if someone steals it, most likely, is because most thieves who steal these kind of electronics know that the first thing you always do is wipe the device. Because as soon as you wipe out the data, this feature here goes away. Most thieves are not interested in your data, they're interested in reselling the device. Next, we have the ability to sync certain types of documents. Now, if you've never heard of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, they're the equivalents to Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. They're just made by Apple. Now, what's nice with this is I can start creating a document on my computer, and when I go to save it, the first thing it asks me is, do you want to save this to iCloud? If I do, I could pop onto my iPad or even any computer, even if it's a PC, go to iCloud.com and pick right back up where I left off. The next feature I want to talk about with iCloud has to do with syncing your passwords. Now, in the Mac, it's referred to as the keychain. That's the part of the computer that stores all of your passwords. Now, I always like to give a little warning about using iCloud for this feature. The reason why I don't really approve of it personally is because it requires you to use Safari. If you've taken our other classes, you've probably heard me say this. Safari used to be wonderful, and then Google Chrome came out. And Google Chrome has proven to be faster, more reliable, and it automatically does synchronize all of your passwords, accounts, etc. So if you love Safari, this is going to be a great feature. If you don't, you're probably not going to care about it. The next feature we're going to talk about has to do with photos. Now, photos and the way that they work with iCloud is the number one misconception that people seem to have. So let's go into iPhoto. When you take a photo with your iPhone, a couple of things happen, and I've noticed that a lot of people seem to be very confused by this. When you originally take that photo, there are two copies of it that are stored. One is on the camera roll, and the other is stored in a portion of iCloud referred to as photo stream. Now, those photos do not count against your amount of iCloud storage. Another thing that you should be aware of is that the version of the photo that goes into photo stream is not the full resolution. So you may have noticed that a photo that you took on your iPhone, for whatever reason, just doesn't quite look as clear and vivid on your computer if the copy on your computer is purely from photo stream. And that is the reason why a lot of my friends who take iPhone photography seriously have stopped using iCloud specifically for that feature. Another thing you should know is that it only keeps that photo on the cloud for either 30 days or until you have 1,000 photos. After that, it gets cleared out. A lot of people believe that iCloud stores your photos and that it acts as a backup. And if you hear them say this, make sure that you correct them, because it does not. Now, another thing you can do with iCloud in regards to photo stream is create something called a shared photo stream. Most people who do this are going to do it from their phone, but it's a way that you can take photos and instantly share them with your friends. Just make sure that if you do this, they're, let's just say, appropriate. The next feature that you can use with iCloud is the ability to synchronize certain types of purchases that you make. So let's say that I am on my computer and I go into the iTunes store and I purchase the brand new Lady Gaga CD. Using iCloud, I can go here into iTunes, Preferences, and here under the Store tab, I can have it automatically sync those purchases with all of my other devices. So without having to plug my iPhone or my iPad into my computer, I can already have the music when I turn it on. Next, I want to talk about how iCloud works with Windows. This is something you'll find that a lot of people don't really talk a lot about. And I want to talk about how it works and also clear up some misconceptions here. In order to get iCloud to work with Windows, you need to download this little file here. It's a program called iCloud Control Panel for Windows. You can get it just by Googling it. It's on Apple's website. It's a very small file. Now, Windows works a little bit differently compared to Mac, obviously, but what it will do is when you take those photos, it will store it in an actual folder instead of loading it into a program like it does on the Mac. Now, in regards to bookmarks, you can choose different web browsers to have it sync with. And the next is the tricky one, which has to do with mail, contacts, calendars, and tasks. Now, there are different programs that you can use on Windows to get that data. Some people use Windows Mail, others use Outlook, others use Thunderbird. I have always personally recommended Thunderbird because Outlook has never ever played well with other services like iCloud. Now, it does play well with certain types. Google, as an example, it works perfectly, but it doesn't ever work well, it seems, with iCloud. The big example that people seem to run into is they may put a calendar appointment on their computer and it goes perfectly to their phone. But when they do it in the reverse order, it never seems to go into their computer. So if you are on a Windows PC and want to use iCloud, I would suggest that instead of using iCloud, you may want to consider using the different Google apps out there, like Gmail, Google Contacts, and Google Calendars instead to synchronize your data, just because it seems to be a lot more reliable. Well, everyone, we have covered an awful lot about iCloud. As I said, this is a very complicated topic to discuss with a large group of people. I hope you learned something from this, and if you did enjoy this video, please consider giving us a little thumbs up like button if you happen to be watching this video on YouTube. If you're watching it on our site, give us a little comment in the comments section and let us know if you liked it. This is David A. Cox with PCClassesOnline.com. If you've never heard of our service, please go to our website. We are a 100% free public service, currently with members in over 160 countries. Take care, everyone. Bye.